want to show you how you can create lead magnets that look like this inside of Canva. Ready? Let's go. For the best advice and tips on growing your audience with fresh content ideas, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll get my latest uploads every week. Now, there are different types of lead magnets you can create on Canva, anything from a simple checklist to a full-on mini ebook. It could be a presentation that they download as a PDF or a worksheet. In this video, I'm just going to be focusing on creating something like a mini ebook. So before you get started, you should have a good idea of what it is you are going to put inside of the lead magnet and the structure. So the structure of a mini ebook type of lead magnet is going to include a cover page, an about page, something to let them know who you are and what you're all about, an index of the contents and what's covered inside of the ebook, and then the actual pages of the content, like checklists, a roadmap of some kind, some text where you describe something or tell a story of some kind. And then the final pages are going to be a call to action where you add links. If you are looking to create a worksheet within this lead magnet, I'll show you a little bit about how to do that as well as how to create it in a way that's fillable online. So if they download the PDF, how can they fill out the document as well? So we're going to talk about all of that, but the first thing is to understand what you're creating and the structure. And then it becomes so much easier to find templates and things inside of Canva to help you create. So what I've done here is just given an outline of the types of pages that I am going to need inside of my lead magnet. So first, we want to look for a cover template, then an about template, an index text sheet where we might just have some text, a worksheet where they might be able to fill it out, a checklist or some kind of a roadmap, and then a call to action page. So back on Canva, we can start with a blank document that's the size of a printable piece of paper. So we'll go to create design, and what we'll do is we will select A4 document. So this will give us a good starting point. And under templates, you can type in words associated with the elements that you're going to include inside of your lead magnet. So we'll start with a cover. So we'll type in cover, and you can scroll through different templates for magazine covers, ebook covers, and things along those lines, and look for something that fits. And so I'm going to pick this template right here. This template happens to be a pro template. If you are looking for things that are more suited for a free account, you'll need to hover over the template and look for the word free. So I'm going to actually choose this one that's for a pro account, and it will auto resize certain things on templates if it's made for a different size. But you can also adjust. So I'm going to use this as my cover and then click add page. And let's see, what was the next? It's the about. So I'm going to type in about and see what comes up. So there's a few different examples from social media posts to Instagram stories, but I happen to like this one. It looks like it's formatted for an Instagram story, but when I click on it, it will resize itself to the A4 size. So we're starting to put together a book. Now the colors and the text aren't going to be the same, but there's a quick way to customize it. And I will show you that towards the end once I have all the sheets together. So now that we have the about page and the cover page, now I need the index and content page. So we'll come back to the search bar and you'll just put in index. And we'll be provided with a few different examples. I don't like that one, so I'll put table of contents instead. And you have multiple different examples. And so I will search through and find the best one. So I chose this green one. And you can see none of these sheets go together right now, but it's gonna be amazing when you see all of this come together. So the next page is a text sheet and a worksheet. So again, we'll just type in text and see what comes up. And you can see different templates like Instagram stories and books and things. Now, if you're having a hard time finding something that goes with the things that you've already selected, I do have one tip for you. I will add this other page here and go back to the recently used templates. And one of these I happen to like, so I'm gonna click on the three dots and you can click on view more by this content creator. When you click on that, it will open up all the templates that this content creator has shared on Canva. And you will find many Canva templates that go together with what you've already chosen. So this can be a great resource for additional Canva templates to go with what you've already liked. What I've decided to do is just grab one of these Instagram story templates from this content creator and customize it so that it includes text more than it currently does. So I will just customize this for my use, which is another great resource. If you aren't finding what you need, you can simply create it. So now I've customized this sheet and I might want to add a couple more just like it. And after I've added text, I will look for a worksheet, which you can just type in worksheet. And you'll see what comes up is probably more suited for children. So I'm going to rephrase this to, instead of worksheet, just put in question, because I happen to know that Instagram story questions or polls are often shared in templates, and you can customize these to be suitable for a worksheet. So if you're asking questions on Instagram stories and you're also asking questions in your lead magnet, you can customize the same type of template for both uses. So I will click this one right here, and now we can customize this entire thing as a little mini worksheet. What I would do instead of keeping it this size is I would modify the size of these elements and make it bigger. I will likely change things about the font size and the colors, but like I said, all of that will come together towards the end. All right, the last two sheets we need is a checklist or a roadmap and a call to action. So we can type in roadmap. You can see different versions of roadmaps. I saw one in particular here, and so I'm actually going to expand this and see what else comes up. I discovered this little roadmap right here, and last but not least, we need a call to action sheet. So if you are selling a course or have a service, you can add a call to action sheet at the end of your lead magnet. So I typed in call to action and I was provided with many different templates to choose from. So what we're looking for is potentially a mock-up for your website with a button. That's what I would be looking for on a call to action. And if the call to action is simply for them to follow you on Instagram, then that might be an appropriate call to action. You could also include a, you know, webinar call to action for if you have an automated webinar. But I happen to like this one. And obviously all of this text and colors and fonts needs to be customized. So now that we have all of the sheets inside of our template, we're ready to customize the colors and the fonts. So the fastest way to do that is to go over here to styles and click on your brand color palette and your brand font. Now, this is a feature available to Canva Pro accounts. So if you don't have a Canva Pro account, you will need to change the colors manually. So you can click on an element, go to the color, and click on the color in your brand that you want to change it to, and then click change all, and it will change all of that color throughout everything. But I happen to have a Canva Pro account, so I will use the Canva Pro features. But I'm not going to use my own brand colors. I'm going to use colors suggested in Canva. So I'm going to pick one of their color templates. I'm actually going to choose this minted grove here, and I'm going to shuffle through different versions. I like that one, so I'm going to click apply to all, and you're going to see that it applies the colors throughout the entire lead magnet in one click. Then you go to fonts, and I will choose a font that I like. So I picked this one, and I'm going to click apply to all pages, and it will apply that font across all pages. So you can see how quickly this is now shaping up into a branded lead magnet. Now, what you'll want to do is customize the text and add your photos and everything related to your lead magnet. You'll want to update the contents on the table of contents and then add your unique call to action. Now, on the call to action, this button might say click here to join, and you can modify this button to include a link. So I changed that text to say join now. I'm going to click on the color block and come up here to the upper right hand corner with the link icon. Click on the link, and this is where you will insert the link to your website or where you want them to click. You'll hit apply, and then you're ready to download as a PDF document. So go ahead and click download, PDF, print, make sure all pages are selected, and click download. So here we have a completed workbook, complete with a cover page, an about page, contents, some text, a small worksheet with a roadmap or a checklist to summarize everything, and a call to action. Now, if you are interested in adding a text area that they can click in and add text on their screen or on their mobile phone, you can do that. It's not inside of Canva, but you would use a tool like PDF Escape. PDF Escape is a free online tool that you can use online to upload your PDF and add fillable forms to. So I've uploaded that one sheet, and you can click form field, text, select, and then highlight the area where you want a fillable form. Then when you're done, you can click on this save and download, and you'll be able to download that to your computer, and then you can click on that and start typing in. And if you didn't like the way that that was formatted, you can come back to PDF Escape, right click, and click on Other Properties and modify the properties to the way that you want that form to look. So that's how you can easily create a workbook inside of Canva all by yourself without having to search for the perfect template. You can create something with everything that you have at your fingertips inside of Canva. So now that you know more, what about the next step? I've put together a done-for-you lead magnet template with 65 lead magnet ideas so you can get started right away. You can grab a link to that right below this video. Also, if you're finding it hard to get new subscribers or connect with your audience, I've got a secret society Facebook group where you can join others and connect with other content creators, and you can get a link to that right below this video as well.